A little while ago, I don't know, a few months ago, I did a video on inflammation, which I thought at the time would be the only video I would need to make on inflammation, because I tried to make it as comprehensive as possible. All about background inflammation, chronic inflammation, what causes it, what the problems are, the medical conditions that arise, how to control your inflammation, and how to eat right to reduce inflammation. And of course, I missed something absolutely important. I have been asked by several of you, surely inflammation isn't necessarily always a bad thing. It's a natural process. Why does it happen if it's just bad? And of course the answer is yes, it is a natural process and it does have a purpose. So in this video, I'm going to explain to you what it's supposed to do, when it's good, when it's not good, how to tell and how to manage it so that your inflammation, when it does occur, serves the correct purpose, and for the rest of the time, it's not interfering with the normal metabolic functioning of your body. So welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist and a sportsman. So managing inflammation is very important for me in both those worlds. Now, if you haven't seen the video that I'm referring to, I'm going to link it down below here somewhere in the video notes, and I'm also going to link it at the end of this video. So I urge you please to go and watch it, and if you have seen it, just watch it again, because I don't want to repeat everything that was in that video. It will make this video very long. But let's talk about inflammation and what the point of it is. Inflammation is your body's natural response to a specific physical stress, whether that is infection from a virus or a bacteria or something, or whether that is an injury. And what the inflammation process does is it triggers your immune system to go and start the healing process or to start fighting the infection. So without inflammation happening, you wouldn't know, and your body wouldn't know, that there was something that needed to be attended to. So the inflammation serves two fundamental purposes. Let's say you twist your ankle. It immediately becomes inflamed. Your repair process gets kick-started, and the healing process over the first 24 hours really gets ramped up. The other thing that it does is it swells and it hurts. And the swelling limits the movement around that ankle joint, and the pain makes you less inclined to jump up and down on it. So you tend to rest it. And that is all very important to get the healing process started. What sports doctors and sports physiologists and physiotherapists actually do now, when you have a sports injury, is they do not administer anti-inflammatories straight away like we used to in the old days. Even icing it is not necessarily the best idea unless there is massive internal bleeding associated with it. Then you want to ice it to keep that under control. But generally speaking, the initial inflammation for the first 24 to 36 hours is actually encouraged, both to immobilize the injury, but specifically to get the healing process started, because then the whole recovery process will be a lot quicker. When it becomes a problem is when it doesn't go away and the inflammation for some reason stays. Now, in nature, if you were to twist your ankle, you would want the inflammation to stay as long as possible to stop you running around on that ankle so that it can continue to heal. But unfortunately, the inflammation after the initial process of activating the healing interferes to an extent with the rebuilding of the tissue. So it, over a long period, it will actually slow down the healing process. But nature doesn't have a choice. Nature has to tell an animal not to walk on that ankle. Okay, luckily for us, we are quite intelligent, some of us, and educated, and we understand to treat a sports injury correctly and not run on it. So we can be trusted to take anti-inflammatories, to strap the injury, to ice the injury, to reduce the inflammation, to allow it to heal more quickly. We go to physical therapy, we do the exercises we need to do, and we recover. So we want the initial inflammation, but we don't want the inflammation to then drag on. The chronic inflammation that I discussed in my other video, which I say again to you, please go and watch, is a sort of chronic background level of inflammation throughout your body all the time. That is your immune system constantly activated, all those chemicals flowing around looking for the problem, and the problem's not there. So it is a false inflammation or a false trigger of inflammation, and it interferes with healing, it interferes with lots of metabolic processes and gives rise to lots of metabolic diseases and conditions, which are all covered in that video that I was talking about, that is down here somewhere. And you need to eat correctly and cut out certain foods and exercise correctly and try and get the right amount of sleep to limit that background level of inflammation. That is the chronic inflammation that is going to harm your health. Particular acute inflammation in response to an infection or an injury is very important, and you need to be sure that you have enough omega-6 oil in your diet, which you can get from eggs and you can get from olive oil, because omega-6 oils maintain your ability to inflame as and when the inflammation is actually needed. Now, chronic inflammation is typically caused by tobacco smoke, alcohol, and sugar. So if you smoke every day, or you drink every day, or you eat carbohydrates every day, those are three things that are going to trigger background inflammation. I mean, there are other things, but those are the three main things. So if you have a low sugar diet or low carbohydrate diet, you don't smoke, you drink in moderation, which might mean you don't drink at all, then you are well on the way to managing your inflammation and avoiding a lot of the diseases that are associated with inflammation. And believe it or not, those include things like heart disease, Alzheimer's, diabetes, arthritis, various autoimmune problems. We have a number of videos on a lot of those conditions, but they are essentially inflammatory diseases. So inflammation is important when it's needed. The rest of the time, you really don't want to have it. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing to the channel. Please go and watch the other video on inflammation so you can really understand how you can manage your inflammation. And thank you for watching.